Hi everybody, Darren Watson here again, or for the first time maybe, and today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about slide guitar. It's possibly one of the more misunderstood parts of blues guitar playing, I find, and that people seem to think it's just about tuning to an open tuning and kind of going to town with a slide. Etc. Now if you want to do that, fine, more power to you. But most of the cats that I listen to, modern guys and guys from the past, are playing not as much slide as you think, and what they are playing, they're playing often with a lot of control. There's certainly room for that kind of loose kind of playing as well, but you need to be able to play tight to be able to play loose effectively. So we'll take you through a few basic techniques. I'll try and give you some close-ups as well. First thing when you're playing slide guitar is obviously you really need a guitar that's kind of suitable for the gig. This is a Beltona Southerner resonator. Obviously a lot of slide guitar was played on resonators type guitars, but you can play it just as easily on regular guitar. The difference is obviously you've got to have generally an open tuning, and you've got to have the action tall enough, and that action is the height of the strings off the fretboard. That when you rest the slide, you don't get all this kind of buzzy noise and stuff. How tall? I like it, what I call a medium action, which is that I can still play. I can still play chords, you know. Still play licks with my fingers, so you know, without playing it on the slide. So, but I do use very heavy strings, and I think if you're going to predominantly be playing in open tunings, and if you're really serious about slide, you probably want a dedicated guitar with heavy strings, at least 13s to 56. This guitar has 16 on the E string. Down to 56 on the other E string. And this guitar at the moment is tuned in open G, which is D, G, D, G, B, D. So it's really easy. I mean, without a tuner, if you're an E standard, you drop your E string down to an octave below that D string, you drop your A string down to an octave below the G string, and then you drop your E string down above the D string. So you've got three Ds, two Gs and a B. G, D, G, D, G, B, D. So like this. Right. Now, slide material. Slides are made of a number of different things. You can buy them off the shelf. And perspex or whatever. I personally prefer an actual bottleneck, and I make these myself, just from generally wine bottles, but sometimes whiskey bottles, medicine bottles, whatever. It's plenty of easy ways to do it yourself, or you can buy one off me. You can drop me a line and I'll make you one. Obviously shipping is a bit of a bitch of these things. They're very easily broken, but happy to do it. Now, using the damn thing, you've got your tuning sorted. You've got your slide. I like to play with my slide on my pinky. A number of people play on their middle finger or their third finger. A very few play it on their first finger. The pinky for me, because that leaves me free to play relatively normal chord shapes. And obviously in alternate tunings, they're different chord shapes. While still having access to the slide, it also enables me to damp behind the slide, and we'll get to how important that is. That is touching the string behind it to keep it from resonant overtones. Here, for instance, is without damping, this is a slide. You hear all those overtones? Now, quite different. First thing we need to learn is positions to play. So, obviously, because we're in an open chord, it's relatively easy just to put the slide over a fret, and I can't emphasize over a fret enough. It needs to be on top of the fret itself, not in between the frets, okay? Because the difference is this much. Quite a lot. Okay, so your first position is G. To get your 4 chord, you're going to play on the 5th fret, and because this is a G tune, your root note is actually on the A string. So, now as far as placing the slide, don't get into doing things like, don't actually do the sliding yet, and we're going to get into that later. I just want you to put the slide over the 5th fret and just rest it there. Don't press down, don't, if you can hear that the fret working, you're doing it wrong. It's actually quite a light touch, you're just literally resting it. Okay, so that's your C chord, and to play your D chord, move up and play it over the 7th fret. 1, 4, 5. Now we're going to use, hopefully some of you have checked out my other videos about fingerstyle playing, we're going to use the same right hand techniques we use for those other pieces, which means we're going to be playing quite a bit of just drone bass or even thing, and then but what I want to do is actually play a little piece that will introduce the thumb gradually and just show us some really simple Delta blues slide guitar kind of place to start. It's a huge thing, and when you get into it, it just gets deeper and deeper. There is no end to it. Well, I haven't found it yet in the long time that I've been playing. So I'll just introduce you to this little Muddy Waters tune, and I'll take you through the first few bars on this, and then I'm going to do some later videos that won't be free, just to take you into more detail and help you through. I'll have to excuse my tuning. We're in the middle of the change of season here in New Zealand, and the weather's going hot and cold and hot and cold, so my guitars are struggling. But anyway, Muddy Waters style. Introduction to something like Walking Blues or Country Blues, a pretty traditional tune from the Delta from the 1930s, which Muddy kind of appropriated and made his own, a couple of different versions. How everyone appropriates everything in this music, that's part of the great thing about it. So let's start from the very beginning, and we're really focusing here on the 12th fret. So obviously, just like on a regular guitar, the 12th fret, everything is a whole octave up from. So you'll find a lot of blues artists will use this. Now, I'm adding a lot of vibrato. I don't want you to do that to start with. Okay, to start with, I just want you to slide from the 10th fret to the 12th fret, and we're going to play that triplet, 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, like this. Now you're going to find that it's going to take you a while to get it sounding like that. You've got to put, I actually struggle not to use a vibrato, to be honest, so for me this is just as much a challenge as it is for you. But I really think it's important to start with a clean So part of the way that I get the cleanliness of that note is that I touch behind the, where I'm sliding, where the slide is, which is right above the 12th fret. Okay, and you'll see how parallel my hand is to the fret. I'm just playing the E string at this stage, which is actually a D. And I'm touching with these fingers here, behind. Just gently, so that if you had the slide off, it would be, right? Cuts out all the harmonics. Otherwise, it sounds different. Sometimes you want that, sometimes you want this. Without, with. So we'll learn with first, because it's easier to take it away than to put it on after you learn the other way. So we're going to go 1 and 2. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2. So then we're going to slide from the 11th fret to the 12th fret on the B string. Take it off, do it again. So this is really quite difficult to do cleanly. You can easily go. Okay, but it's not really what we're after. It might be later when you want to play dirtier. Right. Now let's get down to. And I'm taking that off and putting it back on again. And then we're going to play 12th fret on the G string. So the rhythm is 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a. Second time. Then we're going to go 1 and. Now this is really tricky. We're sliding. Okay. So that's 11 to 12 on the B string. And then up to the E string. 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a. Now Muddy puts an uneven bar length in his intro. So then he adds, which is two strings, the G and the B, from the 12th fret down to the 10th. Okay, so we've got so far 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3. Okay, now that's the intro. That should be at least a solid week's work getting it to sound. If you've never played slide before, it may take longer. Okay, guys? I really, really can't emphasize enough how important it is to get this right before we move on. Once we get this kind of sound of the slide, and just play quietly. Don't try and play super loud and get heaps of expression into it. If you've never played slide before, we really need to start with the basics. Just getting a nice clean tone, damped behind the slide. See how pure that tone is? See my right hand here. So the other trick to this is actually damping other strings when you're not using them. So when I'm doing the slide up here, I've got another finger touching the E string so that I'm not getting. I'm getting. And when I hit the E string, my thumb is coming down and touching the B string. So it allows me a lot of clean playing. So That should really be enough for you to start to go on with.